In Yellowstone, we talked about the most simple and primitive organisms. On safari, we met the most advanced ones. In this video, we will try to bridge this gap and understand how we got here. In order to know something about an extinct animal or plant, it has to become a fossil. Fossils are formed from organisms that have hard parts like bones, shells, or stems. These parts sink to the bottom in aqueous habitats. The skeleton is broken down over time and replaced by minerals. Therefore, we know very little about the evolution of soft animals. Mountains and rocks are constantly eroded. Therefore, the further back we go, the scarcer the fossils become. Nevertheless, in China and in Canada, 500 million year old fossils were found. From these fossils, we learned about the rapid development of complex animals that took place at about this time. This is called the Cambrian explosion that took place in the geological period called Cambrian. Strikingly, all the orders and body types that we know today, like arthropods, early vertebrate ancestors, and mollusks, as well as forms that have since become extinct, are already represented in these fossils. It is clear that these organisms developed over a very long period. Life on Earth witnessed since then 5 mass extinctions. Species evolve and become extinct all the time, and most species that ever lived went extinct. However, these were dramatic events during which a large fraction of all species perished. During the worst extinction that took place 250 million years ago, the great majority of both terrestrial and marine animals went extinct. Most rocks in Israel are composed of limestone and were formed on the bottom of the ocean long after this extinction, and they are rich in fossils. These rocks were folded and lifted, and they form the mountain range from Mount Hermon in the north till the mountains of the Negev in the south. Only in the area of Elat, at the southernmost tip, we can see older rocks on the surface. However, these rocks are devoid of fossils. The fifth, and so far last, extinction took place 65 million years ago, annihilating the dinosaurs and many other animals. The results of this extinction are well documented in the fossil record. To learn about them, we will visit now the Ammonite Wall south of the Ramon Crater in southern Israel. Ammonites were large and intelligent mollusks. Their closest contemporary living relatives are octopuses. Their shell was composed of chambers. They lived only in the outermost one. Each time they grew, they produced a new chamber and moved into it. The other chambers were filled with gas or fluid, which the ammonites could regulate in order to control their buoyancy and movement, much like a submarine. The fossils we see here are large and impressive, but there were even larger species that had shells with a diameter of 2.5 meters and a weight of 1.5 tons. What is equally impressive was the large number of species and their extraordinary abundance. When these rocks were formed at the bottom of the sea about 90 million years ago, ammonites were extremely abundant. Ammonites fossils can be found all over the country. At home, I have a big box full of fossils that I picked as a child in the hills near Jerusalem, where new neighborhoods were later built. At that time, fossils were still not considered protected, and we collected them freely. Now we know that one should not collect fossils and especially not remove them from rock strata. The reason we decided to stop here in the heat and the sun is to show you the ammonites that all of a sudden went extinct. This group is the most prominent example we have here in Israel, how a huge clade, rich both in species and in individuals, can completely disappear. Ammonites went extinct during the fifth mass extinction, together with the dinosaurs and probably due to the same cause. A huge meteorite struck our planet 65 million years ago. This impact resulted in an enormous dust cloud that altered the climate for several years. It is, however, unknown why this climate change led to the demise of ammonites. One explanation is particularly relevant to our course, as it is related to the reproduction strategy. It is assumed that ammonites reproduced by a once-in-a-lifetime massive spawning, a strategy that made them particularly vulnerable to catastrophes. All their eggs and plankton-like young ones lived close to the surface of the ocean and were easily wiped out.
This is of course only one hypothesis, and there are other possible explanations.
The ammonite fossils I find almost on every hike are a poignant reminder of the fragility of life on Earth. How easy it is to cause a huge and successful clade to become extinct.
Each mass extinction was followed by a recovery period and by appearance of more complex creatures. For example, the mass extinction that took place 210 million years ago enabled the dinosaurs to thrive. In turn, the extinction 65 million years ago enabled the rise of mammals. As long as the world was ruled by dinosaurs, mammals were small and nocturnal creatures. Dinosaur disappearance abolished competition and predation by them. Mammals rapidly took advantage and grew in size, complexity, habitat and number of species. Human activity led in recent years to the extinction of a huge number of species. The extent of this loss is widely considered to justify calling it the sixth mass extinction. To further discuss this issue, we'll continue now to the biological collections at Tel Aviv University.